contact, impact. I want that daily. Our breath getting deeper, deeper lately. I like that, baby, 'cause I can't get enough.
Dice que no le es suficiente, está mal de la mente. Cuando está solita que entre, música para ponerla en ambiente, yeah. Ella quiere que coma aquella bella, le busque otro. Todo lo que se pone bonito se le ve. Empezamos a pie y ahora andamos en el jet. Vamos a calentar, baby, tú. No se quiere olvidar, lo quiere recordar, baby.
'Cause I can't get enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't get enough.
Latino camp.
Yeah, I can't get enough.
Wait to get started in the NBA 2K21 demo, get my My Player started, and of course, all-time Lakers versus all-time Celtics.
Just out of curiosity, Chris, who has more championship rings?
Yeah, I was gonna talk about the Lakers, but then you bring up that argument, and I really don't have anything to say about it, unfortunately, so that's a low blow.
Let's team the team! Point, standing 5'8", number 20, at small forward, at 5'9", number 25, Tiffany Mitchell, starting at center, at 6'3", number 11, Natalie Achonwa. Starting at the other forward position, 6'1", number 4, Candace Dupree. At shooting guard, 5'8", number 0, Kelsey Mitchell. A head coach for your team. Once again, your Indiana Fever.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to the WNBA on 2K Sports. And tonight, it'll be the Dallas Wings going up against the Indiana Fever. Along with Tim Swartz and Brian Benefitemi, I'm Blake Suniga, and we're happy to have you along for another great game. And looking back at the new playoff format installed in 2016, what stands out most to you guys?
Yeah, I like how the top 8 teams make the postseason regardless of their conference. It's good for the players as they have more of an opportunity to make the cut. And it's great for the fans who now get to see the best 8 teams fight for a title.
Well, I like how there's now four playoff rounds instead of three, and that teams get reseeded after every round. It makes the championship run more worthwhile for players and teams, while fans get more of the action they crave. And the reseeding helps reward the top teams for their hard work in the regular season.
Now here's Agumbawale. Jefferson outside. Six on the shot clock. To the inside. Endor. Count the bucket. Coming off a perfectly placed assist.
Crafty pass work. Getting it down low for the easy deuce.
Mitchell outside. She's covered by Jefferson. Outside of Chanwa. It's hauled in by Harrison.
You just assume she's going to knock those down when she's as open as she was there.
From the baseline. That one rolling around and rims out. Here's Mitchell. The putback.
How big of an advantage is that for a team? Miss hoops turning into made hoops. Achunwa is relentless on the offensive glass.
Jefferson outside. Dupree covering. That shot off. Here's the Fever with the ball. Mitchell guarded now by Agumbawale.
You'll see her hit from very deep, but she isn't a one-trick pony. Mitchell has the skills plus toughness to score inside, too.
Now here's Jefferson. Pass to Endor. Now here's Agumbawale. Over Mitchell. The Wings with another miss.
They've had a cold start so far. Just 1 for 5 from the floor here early.
Now Mitchell, guarded now by Agumbawale. Pass to Achanwa. Lets it go from 14. And again, it's Indiana converting.
Well, sometimes you have a player like Mitchell, she draws so much attention, it allows teammates to get open.
Here's Harrison. Over Mitchell. And another miss by Dallas. The Fever leading. That shot off. Good D by Mariah Jefferson. And first quarter, we're about 3.5 minutes in. Pass to Harrison. Here's Endor. Now here's Agumbawale. Dupree covering. To end the drought. The Wings with another miss. Indiana with the ball. A 4-point game. Left side of Chanwa. Back to Mitchell. Mitchell outside. From outside the arc. Dallas with the rebound. Now Harrison. She hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Endor. Jefferson outside. Off the mark there with the three. Here's the Fever with the ball. And foul called as she misses, and she's going to shoot two free throws. And it's on Mariah Jefferson.
And the Dallas Wings, a team not scared to just let it fly. They will rely a lot on the three ball, usually near the top of the league when it comes to threes attempted.
Shooting two.
first free throw is good. The Wings look to attack from beyond the arc, as you said.
Yeah, as much as they shoot, they aren't the most efficient from that range. They balance it out, though, by getting to the free throw line as often as they can. They play a little bit like the Houston Rockets in that regard.
She hits both from the stripe. Dallas trailing here. Time called here. The Wings decide to talk it over.
They got to be concerned with all the missed shots. Every team is going to go through cold streaks. But when you go through those cold streaks, you have to find ways to stay productive.
Yeah, and the coach might be telling them to try to get to the line, earn some points on some freebies, because sometimes the free throw line can be your best friend when the shots aren't falling from the field.
Harrison, she's covered by Mitchell. Pass to Harrison. Clock at 6. Here's Ogunbowale. True on the 14-footer.
Well, it's tough to stop Ogunbowale when she's letting it rip. She can get those shots off in a hurry.
Out to the wing. Now Achanwa. Back to Mitchell. She's covered by Jefferson. Mitchell's shot's good.
Well, that pick, it worked like a charm. A nice job taking it right to the 10 for the layup.
Jefferson outside. She's covered by Mitchell. Up top, Ogunbowale. Jefferson outside. Knocks it loose. Oop, there's the 24-second violation, so they'll turn it over.
Harris.
So it's Indiana now. Mitchell outside. Pass to Dupree. With her first shot attempt, the shot is good off the backboard.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. Just phenomenal ball movement.
Everyone's looking for the best shot, and it's paid off during this run.
Here's Harris. Dupree covering. Rejected by Natalie Achanwa.
Well, she's 6'3 with length. More importantly, Achanwa has great timing. That's the secret ingredient for a block.
Nice pass there to set up the bucket.
And 10 of their last 12 points have come off assists.
Now here's Ogunbowale. Pass to Harris. Just 5 on the clock. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. Inside, Achanwa. And a foul called on the shot. Got her on the way up that time, so she'll shoot 2.
2 shots.
She was a first-round pick in 2014 by the Fever. But Natalie Achanwa did not make her WNBA debut until 2015, missing the entire 14 season, rehabbing from a knee injury.
Oh.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls. Well, no matter the sport, you know, baseball, football, soccer, instant replay is the hot topic. Brian, how do you think the WNBA handles it?
Well, I think the league has done a great job, Blake. The biggest thing for me is that the most important events are being reviewed. You look at flagrant fouls and you make sure the game is safe and only look at everything once we get into the final 2 minutes.
Totally. You know, I think other sports have started to review every single thing that happens, be it at the start or end of the game. The WNBA has done an excellent job of limiting reviews to just the important moments.
Here's Harris. No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. Here's Samuelson.
Rejected by Tierra McCowan.
Now the Fever moving it up. Here's Mitchell. Again, the miss by the Fever. Here's Harris. Pass to Endor. Thornton. Gray up top. Here's Endor, covered by Vivian's. Here's Thornton. And she can't stop this drought. Another miss.
They've been sensational on the boards to start this game.
Yeah, sensational is a good word for it, Tim. That's good. You usually have the right word for these kinds of situations. Just tearing it up on the glass.
How kind of you, Brian.
Mitchell's shot's good.
They couldn't have dreamed of a much better start they've had here tonight.
Yeah, they came in with a tremendous offensive game plan. It's worked perfectly, and what a lead they already have to show for it.
And you got to give credit to this coaching staff as well. They came into this game prepared perfectly.
And the Wings call time here.
Yeah, coaches, they saw their team giving up a lot of points and wanted to get a break before it got out of hand.
And that's a big part of a coach's job, making sure you keep your players in the best position possible at all times. That's a great timeout.
Outside to the wing on the left. Here's Harris. She hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Yeah, it's her first trip to the line.
Harris taking two shots.
And she makes the first. And the Fever making a change here. That one falls, so she hits both of them. Mitchell outside, pass to McCowan. The putback. Here's Gray.
quiet so far offensively, searching for first points of the game. Here's Harris. Mavungo with the rebound. Outside, Vivian's. Pass to Mavunga. Shot clock at 6. And here is Mitchell. Gray defending. Let's go with a 3. And the Fever hit again from deep.
They haven't been able to stifle them defensively.
No, you know, the contrary. They haven't provided much resistance at all. And in this game, you've got to play at both ends of the floor.
Here's Harris. And she makes good on the layup.
She placed that pass right out in front of her and just let her run into it.
Pass to Mavunga. And here is Mitchell. The 3 is up. No good there. And Dallas the other way now.
What a year 2017 was for Alicia Gray. First, she wins a national title for South Carolina in the city of Dallas. And then just a couple weeks later, Gray was drafted 4th overall by Dallas.
Now here's Vivian's, looking for her first basket still in this one. And she gets the bucket.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Great ball movement.
Great ball movement, indeed. That's an example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
Here's Endor. Thornton up top. Shakes off the strong D and gets the bucket for 2 points. Well, for Gray, what a smooth transition into the pro game.
It was really amazing. And Gray had no issues adjusting, winning 2017 Rookie of the Year with the Wings, a pure scorer capable of huge nights.
Now here's Vivian's. Back to Mitchell. Fires the 3. And Samuelson pulls it down. Pass to Gray. Here's Endor. Out to the wing. Now here's Gray. He's covered by Mitchell. And plenty of contact on the shots, so the 2 free throws coming up. And there's the foul against Indiana.
Alicia Gray. 2 shots.
She knocks down the first one.
Yeah, in Gray's first season, she actually led all rookies in points scored per game, and she was simply effective right from the start.
And that's good as she hits both shots. Mitchell with it. 10 points for her. From deep. She got it up in time, but it just wouldn't fall for her. And a double-digit lead on the scoreboard as we end the first quarter of play. The Fever on top. They're up by 10. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in a moment. A lopsided first quarter in the books as we get ready to begin the second quarter. And what stands out to you from the Fever in this one?
Good effort, very tight defense from them through the first quarter.
Really a big part of why they are up right now. You know, their defense has been on point.
outside. Vivian's pass to Mitchell. Back to Vivian's. And they double up Kelsey Mitchell. Here's Mavunga. Outside Vivian's. Clock at four. Over Thornton. Vivian's misses. Now here's Gray. He's guarded closely.
Had a chance there to cut it to single digits, but it's off target.
Pass to Vivian's. McCowan, covered by Thornton.
Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
At just a huge hole in the defense, and she didn't waste any time going through it.
Dallas with the ball. Down by 12. Gray with it. Here's Endor. He's covered by Mitchell. Now here is Thornton.
Defense is right there.
No good that time. Pass to Vivian's.
The high floater.
The teardrop is one of those, oh no, oh no, oh yes, shots.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, it's been a long time without a bucket. Focus.
Thornton, covered by Vivian's. Here's Endor. Gray, right side. Pass to Endor. Thornton
gets the three to fall.
The transformation of Thornton is incredible. From waived to a WNBA starter. And really, the three-point shooting, a huge reason she's in the league.
Now here's Mitchell. She's got 10. Outside Vivian's. Here's Mavunga, covered by Thornton. And here's Kelsey Mitchell for three. Endor with the rebound. They're looking to trim the deficit to single digits. And here in the second quarter of action with a hair under 2.5 minutes played. Thornton outside.
And a miss there with a chance to cut the lead to single digits.
Right wing. Pass to Mavunga.
Goes to the reverse layup and drops it in.
Three consecutive field goals have come right at the rim. The defense better start buckling down.
Timeout. They're getting exposed and punished down low.
And the wings call time here.
Well, looking at the players who make their teammates better, who tops the list for you guys?
It has to be Sue Bird, the best point guard in WNBA history, a calming veteran presence on and off the court. She just seen so much in the league, so her teammates trust what she says and what she does.
Hold up, Tim. What about Breanna Stewart? I mean, she entered the league with a bang and earned the trust of those around her right away. And she just plays with so much passion that it rubs off on her teammates.
Quarter number two, and around 3 minutes gone by.
Pass to Ogunbowale. McCowan defending. Jefferson, no good.
With the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, and that's firmly in the driver's seat.
Rebounding, it's an effort stat. They've been the more determined team to this point.
Now here's Mitchell.
He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard.
Are you sensing a theme, fellas? Because I am. I mean, they're taking it straight to the bucket every time down.
And why not? And why not continue to take it to the bucket? That's 8 straight points in the paint. They're making this a physical ball game.
Harrison with the ball. Dupree covering. Outside, Agunbowale. Down to 5 on the shot clock. The shot, no good. Good work defensively by Victoria Vivians. Pass to Mitchell. Good on the shot.
And as they continue to dominate, you wonder just how much higher this lead might get.
And it really could get out of hand because their defense has been just as excellent as their offense.
Great overall game.
Back to Thornton. A good finish at the rack off the slick feed.
She might be undersized, the 6'1 forward, but Thornton makes up for it with touch. Finds ways to score down low.
Mitchell outside, and they double up Kelsey Mitchell. McCowan guarded now by Agunbowale. McCowan with the bucket.
Well, this is where she's going to make her money professionally. 6'7 with touch. McCowan will score points in the paint for years.
Now here's Jefferson. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for her. Pass to Agunbowale. Fires it. Rebounded by the Fever.
And that'll increase their rebound advantage. They've definitely been winning that battle today.
And control of the boards has given them control of this game. That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
It doesn't matter how good their perimeter defense is if they keep allowing easy looks inside.
Now here's Jefferson. Thornton, right side. Out to the right wing. Here's Agunbowale. Off target with the 3.
Boy, the complexion of this game would be a whole lot different if she had shot the ball anything like she's capable of.
Vivians with the ball. Guarded now by Agunbowale. And count it! 2 points with a chance for one more at the line. That'll put Tierra McCowan on the line. That's on Isabel Harrison.
And when the topic of quality rebounders comes up, you gotta start including Tierra McCowan in the conversation. Rebounding is an effort game, and she sure brings it every time she steps on the court.
What's up?
And that one misses. Well, Brian, we know McCowan is a force on the glass, but what allows her to be so effective?
Well, she's adapted beautifully to the speed and physicality of the WNBA game because, let's be honest, it's not the same as college. She just has a sense for where the ball will bounce to, and that, to me, is called instincts.
And they've been looking at a sink offensively.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Jefferson, right side. Pass to Agunbowale. Now here's Jefferson. Can they get it? Agunbowale, no good.
And not only is their lead big, but their advantage on the boards is huge too.
They've been the aggressors, plain and simple, outworking them inside. This is crazy. Every shot they're taking right now is finding the mark.
Literally every shot. They just aren't missing. Yeah, and in this quarter, she now has 7 shots with just 1 make to show for it. And you got to think that this is not what she hoped for.
Now here's Dupree. 6 points for her. McCowan with the bucket.
Nicely done. They continue to attack inside. That's 10 points in a row from the paint.
It's now become here it comes and see if you can stop it.
Here's Jefferson. Arike Agunbowale on the wing. Pulls the trigger. And that doesn't go either for Agunbowale.
You know, it's not been the best quarter for her as far as scoring. We'll see if she can get back on track.
Pass to Achanwa. It's not going to go for her. The wings go the way with. Jefferson outside. Thornton, McCowan defending, and here's Harrison.
Pulls it. They get it again. And there's 2 points. Work on the glass, paying off that time.
Such a grinder, always doing the dirty work on the offensive glass. That's what she brings to the table.
Debris can't get it to go.
The D was ready for her that time, and they had to be. She is strong in the paint.
To the paint. Pass to Jefferson.
Now Harrison
tries it from nine.
Rebounded by Candace Dupree. And she banks in the layup.
Man, their offense has really cranked up in the third.
Jeez, that field goal percentage is now in the 60s. It's tough to beat them when they shoot it like that.
Arike Ogunbowale on the wing. The three ball.
Second chance shot.
And it's Harrison with the bucket inside.
Coach has always told me that if you battle for offensive rebounds, you're guaranteed a high-quality shot, just like she got there.
Pass to Mitchell.
Outside Dupree. Mitchell with it, defended by Harrison. Now here's Mitchell. Tight defense on her. And they double up Kelsey Mitchell. Achanwa, covered by Thornton. Here's Mitchell. That one off the back iron and out. A challenging start here. Outside Ogunbowale. Pass to Harrison. Thornton. Now Ogunbowale, McCowan defending. Good D by Candace Dupree.
Her strokes looked a little shaky this quarter. Not much is hitting the target.
To the middle,
McCowan.
That's in, coming off an assist from Candace Dupree.
Veterans like Dupree usually have an advanced feel for the game, and that's part of what allows her to find her open teammates.
Thornton, she's covered by Mitchell. Thornton, left side, over Mitchell, and too long on the shot.
Physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team, and that 10-rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Not to mention what it says on the scoreboard, they're really pushing them around.
Now here's Mitchell. Mitchell, right side.
No good from three-point territory.
Thornton's shot is good.
You can always depend on her to put that lead pass right on the money.
Now here's Mitchell. She's covered by Jefferson.
The drive by Tiffany Mitchell.
Misses from short range.
Solid job by the defense to get in her way as she was going up to the rim.
Now 5 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock.
Double team with Achanwa.
Pass to Ogunbowale.
Jacks up a three.
Unable to get that one to go. And through the first half, a pretty lopsided affair.
Fever ahead, running away with this one. And we will see you back here for third quarter basketball in just a bit. getting back to the action now. It's been a one-team show so far, but we'll see if that changes. One of the stories here, Mitchell getting it done today.
He's been a revelation tonight, scoring almost at will in the first half.
Hard to imagine she'll be able to keep it up for the next two quarters, but you never know. It could be a special night for her.
And welcome back as we begin the second half. So far, not a tightly contested game, but anything can happen. Endor with the rebound.
Well, this is why you need good defenders inside contesting shots.
Yeah, making every shot a tough shot, even in tight. That's a heads-up play right there, guys. Not just on the assist, but also on the finish.
To the right side. Mitchell, right side. Pass to Mitchell. Just five to shoot. Puts up the tray. Rebound, Dallas.
If only she can improve on what's been a shaky day for her, they could really stretch this lead out, don't you think?
Count it.
With the size advantage as big as it was right there, that's exactly what she should do in that situation. Take it strong to the middle.
Now here's Mitchell. That one, good for two.
Excellent work offensively to get that shot attempt into a can't-miss area.
Here's Dallas now. Jefferson outside. Pass to Harrison. Ogunbowale with it. Now Mitchell defending. And Ogunbowale gets it to go.
Three straight makes to start the second half.
Indiana with the ball. Earlier in the game, they held a 25-point lead. And the shot goes in.
She had her head on a swivel and was able to still pick out the pass and get the assist.
Now here's Jefferson, defended by Achanwa. The kick out to Ogunbowale. There's the triple. Achanwa pulls it in.
They're 3 of 4 to start the second half.
Mitchell, right side. Pass to Achanwa. Here's Mitchell. To the inside. That one goes. Count it.
A tough, knowledgeable player with good intangibles. Dupree's teammates are constantly picking her brain.
Now here's Jefferson. Lets it go from 11. Endor controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Second chance buckets, they're always the result of hard work.
She's covered by Jefferson. They double her with Jefferson. Mitchell outside. Mitchell outside. Five on the clock. Shoots over Ogunbowale. But they recover it. Back to Mitchell. Now here's Mitchell. She's guarded closely. Doesn't go that time. And Dallas the other way now. Third quarter of basketball here. A little under 3.5 minutes gone now. Pass to Endor. Arike Ogunbowale on the wing. Shot from 16. Dallas the rebound. Jefferson outside. Can't hit that one. Nice D from Natalie Achanwa. Here's Mitchell. That's in there. Tiffany Mitchell with the assist.
They've shown some great passing on their last few trips down the floor. You got to imagine that. Their coach is very happy with that.
Four straight passes leading to scores. That's just great team play.
Dallas calls timeout.
Really, they're not pleased at all with the looks they've given up inside, and they want to talk to the team about tightening things up defensively.
Well, that's what's got to happen, and I'm sure the coaches will let them know about it. I mean, they're playing some soft interior defense, and that's a recipe for disaster.
Harris. Pass to Samuelson. Now here's Harrison. Here's Gray. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. That's on Victoria Vivian's.
An efficient, accurate free throw shooter. Gray is not the person you want to send to the line.
She's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far.
Take a break. 2 shots.
And the first one at the line is good. So she makes 1 of 2 as the second one misses. Outside Dupree. Count the basket.
Their crisp passing has opened things up offensively.
Yeah, it makes the game easy. 10 straight points off of an assist. That's impressive.
Here's Harris. Pass to Gray. Here's Harris, covered by Vivian's. Here's Harris. Great D that time from Candace Dupree. Got a hand on it. Gray outside. And she drops in the layup off glass.
Uses quickness to elude defenders. Gray is hard to keep up with. Well, guys, I think Katie Lou Samuelson is certainly a player who competes with a chip on her shoulder. Growing up as the youngest sibling with 2 sisters who played collegiate basketball, she was determined to be the best of the three.
Over to the wing. Fader on the way. It's good.
Great teamwork out there, setting the table for one another.
They're playing as one. 5 straight baskets resulting from assists.
Great team basketball.
Here's Harris. And Samuelson, not a player you have to fire up before games. Why is that, Brian?
Well, my name's Tim. We've only done 1 million games together. But anyway, she's a fearless as they come. I mean, Katie Lou has played in some big-time games, played through pain. No matter what, Samuelson wants to be there for her team. That's the mentality that every rookie in the league should have.
Now here's Gray. She's got 5. Misses the step-back jump shot. Outside Dupree to the left wing. Outside Achanwa. Outside Vivian's. She's off on that one. Alicia Gray with a defensive effort. Some tough offensive sets, and they really want to turn it around.
They got to lock in and need a basket just to regain some momentum.
2 shots.
Harris taking 2 shots.
shooting two.
And she can't get the first one. And the second free throw, good. And these guys have had some good motion on offense. Nice assists.
When everybody's involved offensively, it's in a way helping you defensively too.
Pass to Mavunga. The shot, no good.
Well, you love the tough D, especially inside.
And that's exactly what she gives you, Tim. Constantly making her presence felt around the rim.
Here's Harris. Here's Samuelson. Defended by Achanwa. Four on the clock. Here's Harris. They get it back. Endor. Second shot opportunity. And it's good. Fought through the contact. Hit the shot. And she'll go to the line. She'll be shooting her first free throw of the game. So both teams making some changes here.
What's up?
And they're making this a runaway.
Yeah, the only question here for us to follow is how big the lead will eventually become.
Here's Mavunga. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Well, that pick, it worked like a charm. Nice job taking it right to the tin for the layup.
Pass to Samuelson. Gray with it. Thornton outside. Here's Harris. Five to shoot. Wide open look. Mavunga with the rebound.
It's a plus five advantage for them in the rebounding category after that one.
Very steady work they've been doing on the interior. Really a well-rounded effort overall.
And this is our first free throw of the game.
Indiana Fever. Stephanie Mavunga. Taking two shots.
The first free throw is good. Both good at the line. Here's the wings with the ball. Pass to Gray. Banked in off the glass.
Well, you talk about durability, and how about Gray starting in every game her first 2 years in the league?
Pass to McCowan. Vivian's up top. Here's Mavunga. That's in. Coming off an assist from Candace Dupree.
That assist got a little nod from her teammate after the bucket.
Here's Harris. He's got five. A shot by Thornton, no good.
To the middle. Here's McCowan. Count that one as her seventh make in eight attempts. That's a scorching 86%.
She's carrying a lot of the load offensively, and normally that's good news for them.
Here's Harris. Thornton. Dupree covering. Here's Harris. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass.
That's exactly what they're going for in that possession.
Pass to McCowan. Gray brings the double team. Inside. Here's Vivian's. That shot, no good. And Dallas the other way now. Here's Samuelson. The putback. That shot off the mark.
They're enjoying a commanding lead.
And you know the best part? It gives them an opportunity to give their starters a rest.
Yeah, they might not have to come back in.
And the basket by Mavunga.
Now here's Gray. She's got seven. Pass to Samuelson.
Endor.
And that's looks three. Like an illegal pick was set. That'll get the ref's attention.
That way.
Good call there. Her feet still moving when she set the screen.
And she sort of lowered her shoulder into her, too. A move you perfected, actually. But they were going to get her there one way or the other.
Now here's Mitchell. They lead by the biggest margin of the game, 25. With the tip, she hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
This has been a great job of getting into the middle of that defense and scoring from the paint.
You know, really, that's why they're on this run. You get that close to the hoop, and it's a lot easier to drop shots in.
Thornton with it. Dupree covering. A shot by Thornton, no good.
Bodied her up and made her alter the trajectory of the shot that time.
Definitely. Some very sound defense played on that trip down.
Well, got it in close, but credit the tight defense for forcing the miss.
Defense like that ups the degree of difficulty on that shot by about what? I'd say 300%?
308% maybe.
Okay, I like that.
Now here's Vivian's to the paint. And she was fouled in the act of shooting, an opportunity for a three-point play.
Well, you really have to hammer McCuffer. Sometimes it's best to not even foul. Could lead to an extra point.
This trip is her second to the free throw line in this one.
One shot. One shot.
Taken by the Fever in the 2019 WNBA draft, Tierra McCowan was reunited with college teammate Victoria Vivians in Indiana.
And they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off. They got to score.
Pass to Thornton. Over Mitchell. The Wings with another miss.
What's going on with her this quarter? I'm very confused as she still hasn't gotten a shot to drop.
Mid-Ray defending. And here is Mitchell.
The quarter with a money three as the buzzer sounds.
They knew exactly what they wanted to do there, and the timing couldn't have been better.
You just can't end a quarter better than that.
And as we conclude the third quarter, pretty much a blowout. It's been a one-sided affair. The Fever on top, running away with it. And time for a short break. Stay right where you are. The fourth quarter is coming up next. And we welcome you back as we get going into the fourth quarter. The final quarter of play can change everything. So it's Dallas now. Jefferson outside. She's covered by Mitchell. Pass to Mabry. Six to shoot. Baseline jumper, tries again, and the bucket counts, and she is on her way to the line to try to make it a three-point play.
One shot.
And the free throw, no good. Here's Burke. McCowan with the bucket.
They continue to get it inside. The defense struggling to just contain them.
And look, when you make five in a row from in tight like they have, it also just takes pressure off of your perimeter guys.
Great point.
Pass to Jefferson. And she finishes nicely on the layup.
She's starting to turn it on now after a slow start.
Mitchell outside. Here's Burke.
And here's McCowan.
The second chance effort, and she gets it to go.
What a mismatch it's been in the post. I mean, where's the defensive adjustment? They're just getting eaten alive out there.
Yeah, I agree. They got to come up with something. A double team, maybe a sub. This is getting ridiculous.
Here's Gustafson. McCowan defending.
Pass to Mabry. Nice work on the boards, paying off with the basket.
They've shown a little extra hustle on the offensive glass here in the second half. The second chance points are starting to add up for them, and they can use every one of them. Well, her shooting has been outstanding. Definitely, you know, one of the reasons why they're winning this game.
Up top, Jefferson.
Shooting two.
And the first one drops, and the Fever making a change here. Second free throw, no good. Fourth quarter of play, and we're about 2.5 minutes through it. Outside of Chanwa. Pass to Mitchell. Here's Mavunga.
She's covered by Jefferson.
Fires from the wing, and that one goes long.
She had all the space she needed, but just could not find the bottom of the bucket.
To the middle, Gustafson. And she uses the glass on the layup.
Outstanding entry pass. She knew exactly where to go with that ball.
Pass to Mitchell. Puts it up from 12, and she knocks down the jumper.
Really smart. Draw the defender out to the perimeter because inside there's just too much size for her to be effective.
Exactly. You know, if she finds her spot on the perimeter and doesn't force things, her outside shot is going to be hard to block no matter who is on her.
Here's Mabry.
Count that bucket.
Mixing it up inside. Mabry might be under 6 feet, but her toughness showing there.
She's covered by Jefferson.
Pass to Burke. Another shot. And two free throws coming up as she misses that one, drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there.
First personal foul. Shooting for your Indiana Fever. Natalie Achonwa. Two shots.
Two. That free throw, no good. The Wings making a switch here. And she sinks the second. So it's Dallas now. Pass to Gustafson. She's covered by Mitchell. Jefferson outside. Drills the three-pointer.
She might not be the top sharpshooter in this league, but that's not a shot that D can afford to give to her.
She's covered by Jefferson.
Here's Burke. Pass to Mavunga. Here's Mitchell. Lays it up and banks it in.
They'll take as many of those looks as they can get, trust me.
Here's Mabry. Jefferson outside. Gustafson, defended by Achanwa. Count it.
She made that pass to a spot and let her teammate run right into it. That is how you distribute the basketball.
Mitchell outside. Mavunga. Pass to Achanwa. The jump hook. And again, it's Indiana converting.
Easily over 50% for her career from the field. Achanwa takes loads of high percentage shots.
Here's Mabry. Back to Jefferson. Goes back up, and the layup is up and in. Man, they're in complete control.
Everything they're doing, it's been working out. Wow.
Pass to Burke. To the inside. Achanwa, good.
Her touch, a strength of her game. Helps Achanwa complete the pick and roll action.
Here's Mabry. Jefferson. Lays it up and in off the nice reverse.
Very clever passing. She put that ball on a silver platter for her.
Pass to Burke. Mavunga. Down low. Here's Burke. Up again. It's good on the putback.
Those second chance points, they're just like bonus points if you can get them.
Dallas with the ball. Jefferson outside. Pass to Harrison. Back to Jefferson. Mabry. Inside. Gustafson. And she takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed.
Really, that's her strong suit, the ability to find a way through the D and finish at the rim.
Now Mitchell. From 12 feet out, and another basket for Indiana.
What a feel-good story, right? I mean, she has been much more effective in the second half than she was in the first.
Down low. Gustafson gets the bucket.
That's what I call pretty passive. Timely recognition as to where the open teammate was.
Pass to Mitchell. Achanwa. Here's Mavunga.
She's covered by Jefferson.
The jump hook. Misses off the left iron. Ripped away. Here's Burke.
She's covered by Jefferson.
Makes it off the glass. So it's Dallas now.
Pass to Gustafsson. Here's Mabry.
Takes the assist and lays it in. Picked out the pass nicely.
It's hard to find fault with anything she's doing this quarter. Well, offensively at least.
Achanwa with it.
Soft touch off the glass.
Give her another, and as her career has unfolded, Achanwa's confidence has grown and grown. Now she wants to take the big shots.
Pass to Gustafsson. Jefferson outside.
Six on the shot clock. To the inside.
Gustafsson.
Count that one.
Pass to Burke.
And the layup's good off the glass.
Now Jefferson. And here's Harrison. Here's Gustafsson. Here's Mabry.
Shot clock at five. To the paint. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. And we'll shoot two at the line. Natalie Achanwa picks one up.
Megan Gustafsson. At the line for two.
Shooting two.
And the first one falls for her. And the Wings making a change here. So she gets them both. Outside Vivian's. Pass to McCowan. To the middle. Avunga.
Lays it up and banks it in.
Fantastic dish from McCowan. Easy hoop for the team. Love it when a center can move the ball.
Here's Harris. Here's Gustafsson. McCowan with the rebound.
Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
I mean, come on. You think a little tap is going to stop McCowan? No way. She's just too tough.
Here's Harris, covered by Vivian's.
They grab their own miss. That one falls.
Where was the box out? Some easy second chance points.
Those kinds of mistakes on the glass will kill a team.
Pass to Burke.
Kennedy Burke. Two shots.
Two.
First free throw is good.
And so she makes both from the line. So it's Dallas now. Here's Mabry. Pass to Harris. Five to shoot to the wing, right side. Offensive board, Endor. So the whistle blows on the shot. Two free throws for the contact there.
Third personal foul at the line for the wings. Austin Endor taking two shots.
Shooting two.
And she makes the first. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. Vivian's with the ball. And so it's the Fever taking care of business in this one. This game may not have been the most exciting we've ever seen, but you just have to appreciate just what a clinical performance they put on.
I know their fans appreciated it. We saw the excellent defense, a potent offensive effort, and they were pretty much dominant.
And that'll wrap it up.